With the recent interview that the directors for the new Scream movie have done with HelloSydney.com, I, like many of you, have been sat there reading and listening to what's to come from this new movie. And while so many Scream fans are so excited just to have some news or anything about the new Scream movie, I've actually taken what they've said in a negative light, only because I have some real concerns about this movie based on what we know so far and what they have said. And in this video, I'm going to be explaining to you why I'm getting concerned about the new Scream movie. Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you're interested in Scream content or you just like Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. The actual concept of a fan being concerned about this movie, I feel like such a traitor to you guys, because I don't think any of you have really voiced that you're concerned about this movie, and I'm sorry to be the one to say it, because I'm not a negative person in regards to Scream. I am extremely excited for a new Scream movie, and since it's been announced, you've seen all my videos, I am just hyped to get a new movie. But with the actual news that keeps coming through and things that I'm being told, I just feel like this movie is getting worrying for me. And if any of you do agree with this, then you know, that's great. You know, I'm glad that I'm speaking for you guys. This community that I'm trying to build on this channel is so Scream fans can talk and air their opinions, and all I'm doing here is airing mine. So I'm not somebody who works for these people. I don't have any attachment to these producers or Paramount or anything. I enjoy the Scream movies, but if something's not to my liking, I will just say it. So without further ado, let me explain to you why this video is being made. So even though I'm excited for the new Scream movie, and when Hello Sydney posted that they'd done an interview with the producers, I was all over it, I was reading through it, and I was majorly interested in some of the things they were saying, but not in a positive way, because they confirm that it's rated R, and let me just say, in this interview, they don't really confirm or deny or give anything away about this movie. It's really just general stuff that we probably could have already have guessed. So it's not a groundbreaking thing that they've done, but it's still nice that, you know, Hello Sydney was able to get the producers there to give fans just a little something. But let me quote some things that they've said, and I'll explain to you why I am concerned. So the first thing that I noticed was, they said, "We have to make a movie that's a standalone good movie. It has to be entertaining in and of itself, but also has to be part of a franchise that has existed for 25 years. For us, it was finding a way to merge those two things. A lot of it came from the script, where the entry point is accessible to everybody." Now, I want to draw you guys into this quote. Now, remember this quote. "This isn't a movie that you need to have seen 27 other movies to understand, but your experience will be extremely heightened the more knowledge that you have of those previous four." Number one, there isn't 27 other movies of Scream, there's only four. You know, Scream for a horror franchise is relatively small. It's not a huge franchise that, you know, you've got to watch like 10 films before you get to the new one. And Scream itself isn't that old. You know, it's not an old film. You know, it's relatively modern compared to most horror films that are set years and years ago, like 80s films and so on and so on. So the idea that they've not wanted to carry on, you know, from Scream 1 to 4 and sort of do a standalone movie because you don't want people to have watched 27 movies before, it just seems like they've decided that they want this movie to stand on its own. And I'll explain to you why that's a problem to me in a moment. Then it was added, "We have tons of Easter eggs in this thing." Let me just explain to you why this is kind of worrying me a little bit. And you know, you're probably going to think I'm being super negative, and I understand that some of you are probably thinking I'm overreacting to this, but I don't feel like I am. And I'm going to be honest with you guys, I don't actually like the idea of making this movie a standalone movie away from the others, because the fact that they have said that this movie, you don't have to have seen 27 others to get into it, tells me that the lore of Scream and the original story of the movies is being forgotten, and they're going to shoehorn in this whole new story. And whilst I'm looking forward to watching this movie, the concept of them just completely shoving the original story aside, you know, as if it's not important, you know, you don't have to watch the four to watch this new Scream, I just think is a huge slap in the face to Scream fans. And I'm sorry to be so negative about it, because, you know, I am hyped for this movie, and this is a Scream channel, and, you know, I am going to go watching it, and I'm going to be just like you guys, all ready to watch it, and when the trailer comes, I'm going to be all over it. But just sort of saying that they're going to be making this a standalone movie. And some of you may argue with me and say, you know what, they did that with Halloween. No, they didn't. Halloween was not that way. Halloween was a continuation of the original film from 1978. Therefore, because I'll be honest with you guys, I wasn't an overly huge Halloween fan before that movie came out. I went back and watched them through, and I ended up really liking the original. The fact that it was set years ago did not bother me. Or the fact that, you know, there was 27 other films before it didn't throw me off at all. But the fact that they're kind of saying that they want people to watch this movie and it's a standalone movie and it's going to be a movie where you don't have to watch the others, but it will help your knowledge if you do. I'm just kind of thinking, well, don't alienate Scream fans. You know, we are the ones who make this movie. You know, we're the ones who are going to be going watching it. And yeah, you know, there's going to be Easter eggs in it. So that's sort of saying, don't worry, fans, there will be an Easter egg in there relating to the other movies. But for the whole part, it seems like this movie is going to be a standalone movie away from the originals. That bothers me. It really does bother me because, you know, films are just not learning from this. They're starting to do their own thing and they're abandoning the lore of what made their films successful. And because of that very reason, I'm just getting really concerned about this movie. The more that I hear from these guys, the more I'm starting to get worried about it. And it's a real problem for me because I am actually excited to watch this movie. And, you know, any kind of news that comes out, I'm hyped for it. And, you know, Hello Sydney posting such a great interview, you know, that was a really nice thing to do. But I'm just sort of worried about this film. It's like, you know, I don't know how you guys are feeling from these comments, but like, how can you possibly bring out a movie and abandon, you know, the original concept? You know, you don't have to have watched 27 movies. They're talking like this movie or this franchise was like Nightmare on Elm Street or the original Halloween timeline. It wasn't. It's not a long thing. It's four films, and the fifth one, you know, would have, you know, been nice to have carried on the legacy of it. And, you know, it feels like to me they're going to be going down the route of being a soft reboot. And, you know, whilst, we're all excited to see the original characters back, I just hope they give them the justice they deserve. Because if you don't have to have watched the originals or the original four to get into this movie, then what's the connection? What connection do we have to this movie? That's all I've got to say about it. That's all my opinion is. And that's just, you know, a concern for me. And, you know, I am a long-term Scream fan. And this channel is dedicated to Scream, not because of the new movie. It's been dedicated to Scream because I love Scream. And I know many of you do. This is not me being negative. I'm just trying to give my thoughts on this as a long-term Scream fan. I don't know if any of you agree with me on it or if any of you are actually concerned. But drop a comment down below and let me know what you think. Because this is really concerning me. And I'm just sort of wondering where they're going to go with this. And we can't judge too much until the movie comes out, and I fully respect that. I'm going to wait for, you know, possibly a trailer before I properly make my assumptions and jump to conclusions. But I just wanted to know what you guys thought by me sharing this view. So thank you very much for watching the video. Don't forget to like this video because it always helps this channel out. Be sure to join our Brilliant Scream community. Head over to the community section of this channel where we're discussing Scream every single day. There's polls and you can take part in discussions with people about Scream from all over the world. And without further ado, I'm going to leave this video on another Scream quote.
I was up for Princess Leia.
I was this close. So who gets it?
The one who sleeps with George Lucas.